Very good. Alright, excellent. So, let's rock it. Existing social networks that do a great job of managing and maintaining your existing networks. You know, folks you already know. But what about people you don't know? Probably wouldn't rather love to. So, have you ever wondered if there are people around you right now that would be actually interesting and valuable to you to get around, to know, right now, right here? But if you even knew, how would you approach? How would you know that they'd be interested in meeting you? So, what even could you do if someone approached you and sort of turned them down gracefully without sort of invading on your own privacy sphere? So, what if there was a simple way of attracting the kind of people you'd be interested to meet, like a magnet for your pocket, that would help you remove the hassle and randomness associated with meeting and connecting with those new people around you? So, introducing Gauss, the people magnet. That's what we come in. Like I said, my name is Peter Anderson. I'm the guy down in the corner, but more importantly, I'm the four other guys down in the basement working because I can't help them. I'm not a programmer, but those guys block. So, what are we? Gauss is a proximity based real-time people discovery and recommendation engine. Okay, so what can you do with that? Well, I say, we say, there's endless possibilities. So I guess this is audience participation time. When you ever had a conference or event feeling that you ever have food, even after all that time and money spent, you still didn't end up with new and meaningful conventions you had hoped for. Show of hands, did it ever happen? Okay. Did you ever feel the fun yourself with time in your hands but no one to share it with in a meaningful way? Show of hands, please. Did you ever feel sad or frustrated just because you had no one to share something? I did. Did you ever find yourself not doing something because you had no one else to do it? So, basically, have you ever wondered if you could be missing out on the next great connections in your life right here, right now? Then, Gauss is for you. So, let's do it another time. We are actually in the member module product or so-called prototype phase. I'll try and connect you through the screens right here. So, over here, stop the audio, boot up, start the machine. We have the usual suspects of networks. So, we're going to connect, I don't know remote. We come into the app, it's basically empty. So, I go in and I add some stuff. I mean, I have to start a conference, so I need to look for some venture capital over there, maybe one plays in football, maybe I will find the tech round and make sure I like still not working today. So, go back. Now, we take this back there, and we just pop in and carry on with our lives. So, later, when you're around someone, maybe at a conference like this, Gauss will tell you, hey, there's an easy funding guy over here. Someone at least interested in the same topic. So, what do you want to do? Do you want to add them to your network, to your existing network straight away? Do you want to meet up with the world of crazy friends and just meet some random stranger? Or do you want to see each other maybe using FaceTime straight away? So, we go ahead. We try first to add the network. I want to see who's on the other side of this. Alright. So, okay. Send a request. We've got to go now. Welcome on the other side. Incoming outside. Okay. Someone has initiated a network, the connect request for me. Okay, sounds good. I'll accept that. Boom. And it's running and on. Okay, so here I can see both sides now simultaneously. The sender and the receiver. That's me, that's the other one, that's our couple of friends, that's some of the other friends. Okay, we have some social proof, that's a good person. Looks good. I'll add. Okay, so far so good. We've all seen this happening before. There's some similar apps out there. Okay, what can we do different? We provide you with options after you've added yourselves on your social networks. So, we can actually proceed to actually meet up now in the real world. We'll provide you with options for doing that. You can see each other, like I said, with FaceTime, or Tango, or maybe Skype. You can actually schedule a date for later, and a place where you can meet later. So let's say, okay, I'm over here, I want to meet up now. So what happens is, we do not reveal where you are, we don't reveal where the other party are, but we can recommend day, we recommend a place or a corner in the middle where you will meet. And not only that, we can provide you with, we call it the calendarization over there, which is just a placeholder for you to meet someone for the matches at that place. So you will have no problem finding the person. You just discreetly sort of You see on the right, we have Facebook, Twitter, and Foursquare from day one. We're looking into many, many more. The technology of the platform is very heavily based on Python, Pyramid, CRMQ, Django, and we're using web apps and web services because, of course, there's going to be some heavy computing power in the background. So, a little bit about the company. We are completely bootstrapped. We are going bankrupt if we don't get anything wrong. We actually are in the process of securing the first Friends and Family round. We are probably going to close it in July. We still have some spots if you want to be on Friends and Family. So, we think there's a massive market for it. I don't know about you guys. It's not a feature, it's not a product. It is a legal platform, although everybody's saying that these days. So, I want to do a special thanks to Fabian Tucker to bring this competition to my attention. I want to thank Philip, I want to thank Zach for great advice, and thank you, you guys.
Similarly, we discussed how it doesn't have a single player experience. He says it does, but it doesn't. A single player experience usually refers to a service that requires many people to use it for it to be useful. Still having some sort of thing you can do when you're by yourself that makes it interesting. So Foursquare solved this, for example, by introducing the concept of a mayor. So you can use Foursquare to become a mayor of a place without anyone else you know using the service. So I do believe you still face that problem, and it's something to think about. But what I find more fascinating is that is this idea that maybe we already have too many people in our lives that we so-called know. You know, I have, I think, a little bit more than 1,000 Facebook friends, and about our internet culture is that it's lowered the barrier already of who we consider friends. And I think that like the problem that I want solved is making it easier for me to get in touch with people I already know I want to meet in a place. For like your example of a conference, if you're going to a conference, you probably have a good inkling of precisely who you want to talk to. And somehow making it easier to break the ice, I think would be very powerful. I especially think that this could be huge for dating. Being in a place where you're near people that you're attracted to, but otherwise feel insecure about approaching them yourself. I know it sounds really lame, but I bet that something that could do that tastefully would be powerful.
Yeah, that's something. So we have a